commands to install Apache, MySQL and PHP libraries onto the Ubuntu operating system. So I have copied and pasted here. Now it is asking me to enter the credentials. Once again, I repeat the step. So go to the terminal. So once you open the terminal, you copy the steps for PHP, MySQL and Apache, paste it here, then you press enter. It will ask for the root privileges. So once you have given the credentials, started executing the instructions, means the web server, the database server and the parser packages are getting installed. Once again, I say that the installation time always depends on the internet bandwidth available at that time. So there is no fixed time it takes to install the necessary packages. So once the web server, database and the parser gets installed, the Moodle will be sitting over this stack for its operations. Yes, you can see that now the LAMP, Linux, Apache, MySQL and PHP parser has been installed. So now an important step for assigning a password for the MySQL database user. For this, you can issue the command sudo mysql underscore secure underscore installation. This particular command is a new one as compared to the older versions of the LAMP or the WAMP set of stacks to be installed. So here, when you are assigning a password for the MySQL database root user, it has given us the options of the level of securities which you can assign for the password. So that's what the MySQL secure installation is all about. So now I'm trying to give a secure installation password for the MySQL user, and it is asking me whether you want to give a low or a medium or a strong password. So in the beginning stages, you can set the strength of the password to be of low, where the length will be of course greater than or equal to 8. Of course, that is sufficient for us to get on with the installations. So the new password, I am setting it. Please do remember that you can give the same password what you have given for the operating system user as well as for the database user, so that you will not get confused with many passwords for different set of stack packages. So do you wish to continue with the password provided? Yes. And it is asking me remove anonymous users. No. Disallow root login remotely. No. Remove test database and access to it. No. Reload privilege tables now. No. So once it is done, it's all done. The password for the MySQL database user has been set up. Let us try to now install the additional softwares which are needed for the Moodle software to use effectively. So these packages are more related to the PHP softwares. it will be better to select all those packages what the Moodle software is trying to suggest us. But at the later stage, we may have to install other packages too. So let us see during installation what are the other packages that it's trying to ask us. So select all the packages with respect to their commands, copy it and paste it. So this is the step which I'm doing here. Yes, now all the additional software packages which are needed for the Moodle setup are getting installed. So once the additional set of packages that were installed, you can test your web server by issuing the command to restart the service of the web server, that is the Apache, so that the web server knows the details of all the new set of PHP packages that were additionally installed just now. So I'm issuing the command sudo service apache 2 restart. Yes, if there are no errors for the Apache to restart it, it indicates that we can proceed further for installing the Moodle. So in order to install the Moodle, you need to download the Moodle software onto a folder, and for downloading the Moodle we can take the help of the Git application. So for that, first we need to install the Git and get the Moodle core application packages onto a folder. So let me first install the Git package. For this, I'm issuing the command sudo apt install git. Yes, already the git is installed now. Let us go for downloading the Moodle core application packages. For this, if you see now, I am at the present working directory under my user under the home directory itself. For this, for the downloading the Moodle software, that is the core application packages, you may have to go to a alternate path where you can opt for cd /opt, go to the directory. Under the opt, you can place all your Moodle core application software bundle. So once you are at opt, the optionals, issue the command sudo git clone git application git://git.moodle.org/moodle.git. So we are trying to clone the Git with the Moodle so that we can download all the core application packages onto opt folder. Is getting cloning. Yes, it is remotely connected with around thousands of objects to be retrieved from the Git repository. So it is receiving all the necessary objects of the Moodle software, and they are getting stored into the folder called opt. Later we move the packages and objects from opt to other directory, that we will see once this gets downloaded onto this opt directory. It may take few minutes to download the core application objects of the Moodle onto the opt directory. So kindly hold on at this point. As well, please do remember the time taken to download always depends on the internet bandwidth available at that time. So at present shows me around 4 maybe per second, and it's fairly good speed for me to download the objects onto the opt folder. Yes, so once all the objects have been copied from Git repository onto the local opt folder, you may go to a folder named Moodle. By default, there will be a folder called Moodle, M-O-O-D-L-E. So change directly to Moodle from the opt directory. You can see now we are in the Moodle folder. And now try to retrieve the list of the Moodle branch available. In order to see what are all the available branches that you can connect to. Branches are nothing but different versions of Moodle. So here you can check the branches that are available for the Moodle by issuing the command sudo git branch -a. So it shows me from 13, 14, 15, 16, 17 to 31, 32, 33. As well, you can see 34, 35, 36, 37, 38 and 39. So these are all the different versions of the Moodle which are available. And of course, as I mentioned to you earlier, that we are now focusing on the version 3.7. So if this particular process of branching to the necessary git branch doesn't end, you can as well abruptly close the window and open a new terminal window and issue. Please go to the Moodle folder once again. So I'm issuing, first I'm going to the opt directory, then going to the Moodle folder, and now I'm issuing the command sudo git branch. Look for the tracking of the Moodle 3.7. Don't please give the 3.7, you can give 37, which is the stable version, and try to download it from the repository. It is asking for the root privileges. Yes, now we can see the command branch Moodle 37 stable set up to track the remote branch Moodle 37 from the origin. So once you get the response, please check out whether you are able to download the 3.7 version or not by issuing the command sudo git checkout moodle_37_the_stable_version to check whether yes we are able to switch to branch Moodle 37 stable and your branch is up to date with the origin Moodle 37 stable version. So once we have now downloaded the Moodle and you have selected the version of the Moodle, here we need to prepare our local repository so that the Moodle runs properly. For this, please copy the objects which have been available from the Moodle to another directory path where all our necessary applications are going to be run under that particular path. For this, I am issuing the command sudo cp hyphen capital R repository space slash opt slash Moodle. So from this Moodle directory, we are now copying all the objects to another location where the location path will be slash var slash www slash html. Please do remember this particular path for our web application to be executed under this particular path. So once all the files have been copied, you can as well make another directory called Moodle data where you are going to store all your Moodle's material. So for this, I am a directory with the command sudo mkdir space slash var slash Moodle data. So sudo mkdir slash var slash Moodle data is the folder where you are going to keep all your necessary materials. And I'm changing the permissions of this file, sudo change owner space hyphen capital R www hyphen data space slash var slash Moodle data. You are changing the ownerships of the folder as well as you are giving permissions for that particular folder by issuing the commands. Of course, all the set of commands I am uploading onto the Moodle. You can as well see the step-by-step process. So I'm just changing the permissions of the newly created Moodle's data with all the read, write and execute permissions. And as well, I am now setting the permissions for the Moodle folder which is on the var www.html path to not to have rewriting permissions. For this, I'm issuing the command sudo change mode to 0755 var slash www slash html slash Moodle. So now you have set up your local repository under the path var www.html. Only thing is, now we have to make sure our database server is up and the database server, the PHP and the web server gets the necessary communication to run the Moodle software. So for this, there are a few changes to be made for the database server. So first, open the server configuration file of the database by issuing the command sudo space vi space slash etc slash MySQL. So please do remember the MySQL, PHP and Apache, all the packages were installed under the etc folder. So now the database server configuration file is available under the MySQL folder of the etc. So MySQL, I'm issuing the command sudo space vi space slash etc slash MySQL slash MySQL dot conf dot d. D indicates the server file, then followed by slash MySQL d dot cnf. So once you open the database server file, please scroll down to the basic settings, the basic settings of your server file. So by default the base settings will be with the port number 3306, the base directory is under the user, temporary directory under the temp folder. So under the basic settings, insert the following commands. The command number one is the default search engine to be of InopeDB. So the default storage engine is the InopeDB, followed by the InopeDB file per table parameter value is being set to 1. And InopeDB underscore the file format can be set to InopeDB underscore file underscore format can be set to Barracuda. Barracuda format, then you can save the file and once you have saved the file, you please restart the database server by issuing the command sudo space MySQL sudo space service space MySQL restart. So once we get the command prompt without any errors, it implies that the database server has restarted it. So you can as well cross verify by issuing the command sudo mysql hyphen small u root hyphen p indicates the password it is asking. So you can as well type the command what you have set for the database user. Once you have successfully logged into your database, you will see the MySQL prompt, and the MySQL prompt is asking for to issue the commands which are related to your database system. So once you are logged in, let us create a database. Create a database by name Moodle. So you are creating a database with the name Moodle where all your objects information can be stored with default character set. To UTF-8MB4, which is a new character set fonts. That's what the Moodle is now accepting to us. So UTF 8MB4 underscore Unicode underscore CI. So you are creating a database with a specific character set fonts to be used. Once you get the query okay, it implies that the entered statement is correct. So basically the UTF-8 is a full range 4-byte support for different character fonts, which includes emojis. So now let us create another user in the database by giving a specific password to that particular user. So for this you are using the command create user, the same user name what I have given for the operating system too, as well I am giving it for the database too, so that I will not get confused between the operating system users and the database users. So create user nav.